There are 3 billion Prochlorococcus in the ocean. That's 10 to the 27th, or an octillion. This picoplankton is so tiny, a drop of seawater contains 20,000 of its cells. But together, their mass adds up to that of 220 million Volkswagen beetles. And they cover a vast swath of the planet, living between 40 degrees north and 40 degrees south. Since their discovery in the 1980s, these ocean-going microbes have opened up world after world to researchers, helping us understand microbes, oceans, ecosystems, even the rise of animals on the planet. Though Prochlorococcus, like other microbes, reproduces by dividing in half, not all of them are genetically identical. Instead, over time, they have separated into ecotypes, strains that contain different genes better adapted to their environment. At the surface of the ocean, where nutrients are scarce, high light-adapted Prochlorococcus have a sleek genome of about 1,700 genes and can still grow on almost pure seawater, carbon dioxide, and sunlight. In low light, as deep as 200 meters, their genomes bulk up to as much as 2,700 genes to help them capture light and nutrients in the deep water. But there aren't only two ecotypes of Prochlorococcus. There are thousands, each with its own genetic repertoire. So far, researchers have estimated there may be more than 80,000 different genes in the Prochlorococcus collective. That's four times as many genes as we have. Even more abundant than Prochlorococcus are their vesicles. These are tiny membrane-bound packets that contain DNA, RNA, and proteins. They're thought to act as a food source, decoys against viruses, and a way of sharing genes. If each Prochlorococcus buds off just two vesicles, we're talking many, many more Volkswagens worth of Prochlorococcus products in the ocean. Prochlorococcus's sheer abundance and photosynthetic talents make it a huge player in ocean food webs and climate. Recent analysis of the evolution of their metabolism suggests that as the genome became more and more streamlined, they lost certain pathways, causing them to offload carbon and building up a hospitable environment for other ocean critters. And new research suggests that as this population grew, it helped fuel the explosion of early life in the oceans and the rise of oxygen in the Earth's atmosphere, giving these tiny life forms a chance to shape something much bigger.